Welcome to our YouTube channel. Like our videos, and if you get a chance, share them with your colleagues. Please leave comments and we'll get back to you. Download our free manual. There's a link in the video description. In this lesson, we're going to be looking at creating a look-ahead schedule. Let's start by opening P6. A good look-ahead schedule can be 3-week look-ahead, 4-week, 6 weeks, sometimes a 3-month look-ahead will help project teams plan and coordinate their work in the near term. In this section, we're going to build a 3-week look-ahead. A look-ahead schedule will contain typically 2 major components. One, a good filter to drill down into those activities included in a look-ahead schedule, and then the bar chart screen to make it nice for presentation and easy to read. Let's start with the filter. I'm going to open the filter dialog box by selecting the filter icon in my icon bar, and I select New. Let's name this Lookahead Filter. Now my Lookahead Filter, I'm looking for activities that are going to occur within the time frame that I want to represent. 3 parameters need to be selected. 1, the start. The start is within range of, this is the bottom selection on this menu, is within range of, and I want to select my data date minus 1 week, minus 1W. A good look-ahead schedule will usually look back 1 week as well. My high value is going to be my data date plus 3 weeks, plus 3W. This filter parameter will select any activity that's starting within the range of my current data date minus 1 week and my data date plus 3 weeks. I also want to select any activity that may have started earlier than that, but is finishing within that range. To get those activities to show up, I can copy and paste the same parameter and just change this selection to finish. The third parameter that I want to select, I select by selecting add, and then I want any activity that has a status. So I select activity status equals in progress. This parameter will select any activity that may have started prior to this selected window and is finishing after the selected window. So the start and finish date are not within this range, but they are currently ongoing. Finally, the last thing I want to make sure I do is select any of the following parameters for my filter. If I have all of the following selected, nothing will show up because no activities will meet all 3 of these. So let's change that to any, select OK, and select apply. Now, to set up my screen, I've got my filter working. Let's turn off our headings that are empty. I'm going to go into my group and sort box, select hide if empty, hit apply, then OK. And now I've selected down to just the activities in my look ahead time frame, plus just the headings that those activities are incorporated into. Now let's work on the bar chart. Let's spread this out a little bit. Let's start with the time scale. We want the time scale to start on my data date minus 1 week. That's the beginning of our look-ahead schedule. And then I want to make this time scale be able to show the particular days of the week. So I'm going to select my date interval as week and day. There is my time frame that I want to show. Now, one more thing that I like to do is to get some good grid lines to make it easier to read. Usually in a look-ahead schedule, project schedulers and field people like to see what day of the week activities are starting and finishing on. I can show that by right-clicking, set bar chart options, sight lines, and I want a major sight line. I turn that on, save that to a week, and my minor sight lines to a day. Click OK. And now it's easy for me to see. This activity is finishing on Monday. These are going through up through Thursday, and this activity is working through Friday. Now let's check out how to print it. Let's go to Print Preview. Now this is not a very good looking 3-week look ahead schedule. So let's clean this up. First I go to my page setup. I select fit time scale to one page wide, but now I have to tell it what the time scale parameters are. I'm going to set this as the same as my 3-week look ahead, data date minus 1 week to data date plus 3 weeks. I apply that, and now I have a nice 3-week look ahead schedule ready to print. Let's save that as a layout. I'm going to close this, set view, layout, save layout as look ahead schedule, save it, and now I can open and switch back and forth from various layouts right to my 3-week look ahead schedule. View, layout, open. I'll go to my detail bar chart. There's my entire schedule. Go view, layout, open, and go right to my look ahead schedule. And it's ready to print. Thanks for watching. Now don't forget to like our videos and share with your colleagues. Please leave us comments.